Hey everybody, this is Nick and welcome to lesson number six in our miniseries on how to make a visual infographic inside of PowerPoint. Thanks again to the Visual Capitalist over on Instagram for the inspiration behind this video. You can go ahead and see their infographic. I'll link above and below to that. But this is gonna be our finished product here on the slide. You can see in our previous lessons, we made a beautiful visual header. We have made the United States map, the Choropleth map or the heat map. And now what we're gonna do is we are gonna make the base map for our city. And it's a little bit different here. So I'm going to go over to our slide here. I'm going to escape out of this. And remember from our last lesson, we made this United States map right here. What I'm going to do right now is I'm going to duplicate this map. So we're going to create a copy of this map and we're going to work with some of Excel's behind the scenes settings and data types to try and go ahead and map the cities here so that I can get the exact locations for the cities on this map. So go ahead and push Control D to duplicate this map. I'm going to go ahead and just kind of place it right on top of that other map. And what I'm actually going to do when I right click and say insert or edit data in Excel, the data source window is going to pop up. And you can see here that I have my states, but what I want is to have my cities input from the infographic. So I'm going to go ahead over to this Excel file. I had already written down my city. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this. Remember, we have these number eights here. Those are kind of meaningless, but we just need some value here. So I'm just going to put the same value for each of those cities. I'm going to go ahead and copy these. And I'm going to go ahead and paste this in. And I noticed that Los Angeles is spelled wrong. So we're going to have to make sure to update that. And what I'm going to do now is close out of that. Now, you can see on the map, nothing's really changed. But what I want to do here is go ahead and say my map charts works best with geographical data, such as state, province. So what we have to do for cities is we have to change this data to the geography data type. So I'm going to go ahead and edit the data in Excel again. We're going to open that data source. And what I'm going to do, let's just maximize this window here on the screen so that we can see it. And what I'm going to do is highlight all of the cities, and we're going to go to the data tab. Go over to the data types menu here and geography. Now you'll only have the geography data type if you are working in Microsoft 365, you have a Microsoft 365 subscription, or if you're working in the free version of Excel online. So be mindful of that. You might not have this geography type data type just yet. So click on that. You're gonna go ahead and you'll see these little cards, these little map cards right here tell you that it's become a geography data type. Let's close out and see what happens to our map. Now I can see that I don't really see anything's changed here, but let's go ahead and actually right click on the map and say format data series. Let's go over to series color here. And right now it's just set to that same gray background. So let's go ahead and just change the lower value to this bright red and the maximum value also to the same bright red. And now you can kind of see I have dots right here. It looks like maybe the San Francisco and San Jose right there, Los Angeles and San Diego right there, little tiny dot for Miami. And then up here in New York, we have Boston. If we zoom all the way in, you'll be able to see those cities a little bit better. So those cities are mapping right on top of that map. Now, a little trick that you could do, if you wanted to keep this map, we could keep this map, or what I could do is right click, we'll go to format data series, and here's, I just want to show you this because this happened to me when I did this. You can say under map area, you can say only regions with data. When you do that, it's only going to give you the cities, but you can also see that the plot area kind of changed. So all those cities sort of come right off the map. So let's go ahead and undo this. So if you wanted to just put these cities on top of the Choropleth map, the heat map that we have below, let's just go ahead, right click the map, say format data series, go over to the paint bucket, and let's make all of the other states, all of the states, no fill or no line. So let's go ahead and say no fill. That's going to make them blank. And now you can see it revealed the map underneath, and the cities are in red. So now what I can do is I can start making these custom icons and text boxes, these little pin markers for each of the cities, and I can place them right on top of those cities on the map for an exact location. So I hope you like this video. This video was all about using the geography data type in the Excel filled map to put cities onto your map, to map cities onto that map. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Make sure to go above and click on the link or go below to look at our mini series on how to create a visual infographic from scratch right inside of PowerPoint. I had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you next time.